racing shop. Right after a great weekend for you, you scored your third win in the UARA series at Rockingham Speedway. The only driver to get a three-peat there. Tell me about that race.
It was awesome. Everything worked out the way it was supposed to work out for us. So we definitely didn't have the race car to run away with it or to lead every lap, but they don't pay for every single lap, but they pay for that last one. And we started 12th, just worked our way up there, and I kind of felt out what the car had. And we just put ourselves in the right position. A couple people had bad luck, and we ended up being the receivers the good luck out of it. So Lord willing, he gave us the right opportunities, the right equipment, and held everything together on the car, and we ended up getting a victory lane for the third time. It was awesome.
You've been doing the K&N this year. You've got this modified that you're sitting on that you're going to run this weekend, the Caraway. But that was kind of like a one-off for you to go back to the UARA. Is this something that you're going to constantly do? Because it looks like you're kind of unstoppable over there at Rockingham.
I wouldn't say unstoppable. Everything comes to an end. It's like Jimmy Johnson has 5 championships. But hopefully I can keep driving that 34 car. So it's pretty good. But we'll have to work on it a little bit because the competition is slowly starting to creep up. And it gets harder and harder every time we go back, but I'm sure next time it's going to be even harder, the competition will be better. But when we go back there November 3rd, hopefully I can race that late model, this modified, and the K&N car, and hopefully try to seal up the K&N championship there. So I wouldn't say I'm unstoppable there, but I definitely have a good feel for that racetrack and what I need in a race car when I go there. And also confidence level is pretty big when I go back there too.
Well, speaking of competition there, you had to fend off a green-white checker. Ronnie Bassett dumped under you. They're going into turn one, 3 wide. What was going through your mind there?
I was just there was nobody stopping me on that restart. I don't care who was going to be in front or what happened. I wasn't going to lose that race. I don't care if that guy got up front or whatever happened. If I was being pressed from the back, I wasn't going to lose that race after I got the lead there. And I even told myself when I was running second, coming for the green, I was like, man, sucks for everybody else because they're not going to win this race. And I'm getting this third one. I don't care what anybody has to say about it. So he hit his clutch slip in that last restart, and I got a little bit of gap and drove away and come to the checker.
Be excited.
Woo!